refund, then these hippos are going to get displaced because there'll be no water.
Because there'll be no water.
There'll be no water. And you see these things are.
And just looking at what has happened in the last 30 years, you know, we've completely lost the wild dogs. We only have maybe two or three parts. We used to have an antelope here called the roan antelope. It's not there anymore. The kudu used to also occur in some places here. You don't see them anymore. We are told by people who have been doing research here and counting wildlife, who are doing it from the government, that on an average, 60% of wildlife has been lost in 40 years. Now, 60% in 40 years, how many more years do we have before we lose everything?
Right.
You know, that's quite scary.
Listen, we've got to get together as a species. You know, we can't just leave it up to specific countries and leave it up to specific to solve their problems, because they're not getting solved. The situations are deteriorating, and some places are going to lose things forever, permanent loss.
Yes.
You know, permanent loss. So I felt like, you know, this could be a situation where we really, really begin to unite people around the world who care just as much as people here in Africa care. You know what I mean? Dear Dad, a son always looks up to his father. He looks to him for guidance. Learning about who his father is can give him an insight into who he could possibly become. As a child growing up, I learned two things about my dad. I learned that at different times in his life, he embraced music and law as both a passion and a profession. In the field of law, I found that there was no music, while in the field of music, I found that there was no justice. So I decided to form something new that had never been done before in order to unite these two things that I had learned to embrace from my dad.
I've actually done about 700 concerts, jazz and peace concerts, his organization. In fact, at the United Nations, he brought together Israeli, Palestinian, and American artists, and this event was actually hailed as one of the biggest cultural events of our time. He's been hailed, in fact.
This opportunity to meet you and to see your land and your people and your culture.